Welcome to Weld.com. I want to say weekly, man, this happens a lot. This happens too much, and it's really starting to concern me. It's always concerned me, but more and more. We get requests, questions. Even my former students will do it, and they'll say, hey, I got a weld test tomorrow. Can you help me out? Well, you know I want to. What's the weld test? I don't know. Well, you know, I can't help you if you don't know what's going on. A lot of times if somebody might say, well, it's a pipe test, 6G. Have you practiced? And they go, no. And I'm going, golly, you know, you want me to walk you through this whole test? You've never even been in the 6G position. Wow, that makes it a little difficult. I do this with my students in the classroom. Before I turn them loose on 6G, I get them over here on a bunch of plate so they can get used to running in this position. It's real easy to cut this out. You can do this on a 45. You can also lean this guy back toward you to simulate all kinds of axes. You know, we'll go over here and we'll do like this. Well, it's kind of a simulated 6G because, you know, 6G is either right here facing toward you or away from you, but the whole deal is it's on a 45. And you need to get used to that. You really need to get used to these positions of coming up off the bottom of a piece of pipe, wrapping it around, either switching hands or doing something to prop and come up the other side. Rod angle in reference to the center of the pipe or plate, doesn't matter. I mean, it just makes good sense. You might pass one, and then you get out on a job and they expect this stuff to be done and you're like lost. You gotta practice up, you practice on the job. Some places that's not allowable. Need to be qualified before you step in and try to become certified. That's my point of view anyway. Anyway, let's try to do this and I'll kind of show you. All these rods, I mean, or all these processes run, you know, again, the same thing on plate as it would be on pipe. So if we ran a 60-10, 70-10 root in here, we're doing like uphill, it's a little different because you're now looking, you got to position yourself where you can see this rod. You want to get this root in here burning on both sides, profile be right. You run a hot pass in. There's a couple of options of running your fill pass. If you run a fill pass, I have never run a cap with a weave on a horizontal or a 6G. I always run stringer beads, always. To me, it's faster, cleaner, safer. I don't want I don't want to create the undercut and have it sag down. I don't want to trap slag. So I've always run stringer beads. I used to be really good at it. Kind of getting old and shaky these days. So let me walk you through this quickly. We'll describe what's happening. Again, same thing happens on 6G. It's all on a 45. So you need to get used to it. You need to become familiar with it. It's okay to practice. It's okay to get good at some of this stuff. Let me get my sleeve safety glasses on. I'll be right back. Welcome back. I got my sleeves and I really want to give Weld Porn a shout out here for the hand socks. These babies are really comfortable. I hate to tear them up stick welding, but I'm gonna have my hands in there close. I went ahead and dropped my amperage back down to like 75, and I've got my dig or arc force set at 50%. I don't want to gouge into this. I don't want it real crispy like I would be running downhill. So 75 amps, 50%, 1/8 inch 60-10, just shy of an 1/8 of an inch gap, and about 3/32 on my root face. Now here's where I like to bend the electrode so that I can get in here. I want to point my electrode just slightly up into this plate on the top plate. I want my rod to be straight in reference to the axis of the plates here, so about 90 degrees. So I'm gonna be about like this, and just slightly up in here. I don't wanna gouge this top plate. I don't wanna undercut it, create what we call a cold roll on the bottom. When I get done with this root, I'd like for it to look like a normal uphill. think I'll run that up there and just stop, leave the keyhole so you can see the fit. I'm gonna go buff this out, maybe knock the top of it off. We'll come back and run a little hot pass in here. We have options of going straight to a fill pass, but I wanna run several passes in here to kinda run a bunch so you can see it. Be right back. Gonna run a light hot pass in here. Normally I run my hot passes pretty high, but I ground this out pretty clean. So I only went up to like 85, 90 amps or so. I still wanna leave room to run a couple of stringers of a fill. Again, I could go a lot quicker by running bigger electrodes, but I'm trying to show a bunch of multiple runs in this position here. Okay, I ran the hot pass in there and I just did a buff. I didn't do any grinding. Now I'm running 3/32 7018. I switched over the, got off the 6010 mode on the Renegade and I went to the 7018. I'm up to 85 amps. My first stringer bead fill, I wanna be on the toe of this weld here and I wanna come down to probably about a 16th or so away from this beveled edge. I don't want to get into this beveled edge. It is my guide when I get my first run on my cap. So essentially I want to stack two beads in here and fill this up and I want it to be flush. The mistake that I see a lot of people make on horizontal and 6G is this. They run their first fill pass down here and they get it too far down into this one and maybe even get out onto the plate and then they don't start or don't put the second fill pass in and they've got this deep V trough way down on the top side of this before they ever get to their cap. It's like their fill passes are laid in here like this instead of like this in relationship to the groove. Makes it difficult to cap from that point. So I'm gonna run this first one in and I'll probably be pointing my rod slightly down into the face of this bevel. Let's see how it goes. 85 amps. I ran my first fill pass in here. I shouldn't need a grinder after that. That's why I'm just reaching for the wire wheel buffer. I could do the same thing with a chipping hammer and a hand wire brush. Now my second one in here, I have left room. I should be able to just run this up in here and again, try to get within about a 16th of this top beveled edge. Let's give it a go. Okay, I cleaned this off. First of all, I just knocked it off with a chipping hammer and it came right off, so it was a decent run. I felt like I was kind of moving around. Got my glove hooked on the table and jerked around, so it ran in there okay. The slag came off okay. I was watching it. I'm pretty confident with it. So the first bead of the cap, what I personally watch is I like to watch this bottom edge being consumed, and I try to guide my weld off of that. I also want to watch that I'm having some reinforcement come out here above the plates. To me, that sets the tone for the rest of the cap. So I want to come in here and point the rod pretty much straight in, slightly leaning forward in relationship to the groove here, and I want to come in here and I'm watching down below, and I'm watching to see how much buildup I'm getting behind the rod here for reinforcement. No, surely not. Not slag peel. I definitely do not have undercut on the bottom of this bead, and that's what I'm looking for. So now, and this doesn't look like I have very much to bridge across there, but here's what you got to consider. I'm running stringer beads. My next bead, I really like to fit the toe of the weld into the highest part of this first pass. And by doing that, I know I'll have a little bit left. I've seen a lot of horizontal welds lately. Somebody said they're welding up certain sizes of pipe. And I know I've said this on a video before. Just like this, running this horizontal on this piece of pipe. And it's like they got five beads showing. I'm going, wow, I don't get how it takes that many beads to fill that up. We could use less beads on something like this by running bigger rods, but I'm trying to show you some technique. All right, here we go. We go run bead number two. I'm going to cut this slightly with a thin grinder. I just want to cut it slightly. I'll be right back. I stepped off camera and just lightly, very lightly, scratched into this with an 1/8-inch grinder. I just wanted to clean that top toe of that weld out. I see a couple of specks in here. I wasn't alarmed with it. I'm running hot enough. I probably melted it out of there, but there's just something about it. I like cleaning that up there. So, you know, again, this last one should fit in here, and the bottom of my weld should be about the highest point right in here. And I definitely want to be watching the top edge of this plate, the beveled edge. I did not widen this beveled edge up here that has been untouched is lined up with what I cut into. So I just, you know, there's things about this. I just want to fit this pass in here and watch this top edge and try to hit this profile in here. When you get done on a good horizontal weld or a 6G and you look at it like from the end, it should just have like a normal crown profile. Shouldn't be all weird with one big old bump down here and undercut up there. So let's see if I still got it here on this last one. Alrighty, now what we got here is a simulated 6G position. Well, it's pretty much like horizontal. It's good to practice in this position. Personally, I'd rather just be welding pipe, but in order to show you this and make quick demos of it. Plus, there was the root. I haven't cleaned all the slag, get critical on it, but the root went in just fine, I thought. Good profile. Kind of fun and quick practice of this before you get into some pipe runs. It's way easier to re-bevel these and get used to these comfort zones, and plus you can lean this thing back here toward you in 45 and get all weird and, you know, get used to running these. And then you can get into your pipe. You should be able to just roll right into it and it's not that big a deal. I've seen some really good welders weld 5G and 2G they have a little bit of trouble with, and then they get it and everything's going good and you put a 6G in front of them and they freak out. To me, they're easy. I feel comfortable. Something about the way I move around it, I guess. I don't know. And I've always taken my 6G tests where they're leaning away from you. Some of you have commented about, well, you got to lean it toward you. Really? I didn't know that. I've welded them toward me out in the field, you know, when you can't get into any other position, but for some reason all my 6G tests, I've been allowed to do them like that. It's a 45. I don't know that I've ever heard of a stipulation. And all the people I've tested, you know, I ask them, you want it toward you or away from you? And so anyway, I hope this helps out. Thanks for watching weld.com. Please subscribe to videos. Thanks a lot. Thanks, Weld Porn. These are cool. I like them. They're comfy. Here it is. Here it is, 1st of October. Don't mind. No extra charge for that arc mark down there. I'll sand that off later. Oops. I'm getting attacked by a gnat. Did you bring those down with you today? We didn't see those on the golf course. Why don't we go play golf?
I'm ready.
You're filming.
I can do that on the golf course.
Oh, I was afraid of that. Cameraman doesn't get flashed. She's getting flashed all the time anyway.